Is finding you happy and healthy. So today I thought I would share with you guys our process in renovating our last unit in our fourplex. So as you guys know, we bought this fourplex 2019, right Josh? 2019. So about 2 years ago now, we've been renovating it one unit at a time. And so this is the last unit we're gonna renovate. Demo has officially started, as you can see. So I thought it'd be kind of cool to take you guys through this last unit and tell you guys what the plans are. Our contractor this time has done the demo for us, or he started it for us. I don't think we're actually gonna be doing any of it this time. The unit that we live in right now, we did all the demo and we did a lot of the work ourselves. But our lives are a little bit crazy right now with a lot going on. So our contractor has stepped in and he's doing the demo. And I'm not too sure what we're gonna be doing, Josh and I ourselves, but I'm sure some things along the way. So we'll take you on this journey. So we'll show you everything that's going on in this unit and what our plans are. And this is kind of gonna be an interesting renovation to do. This unit is about 500 square feet, one bedroom, one bathroom. So it's small with a tiny little kitchen, but sometimes smaller places can be very tricky. So Josh and I are gonna kind of take you through here. So as you guys saw, that's the entryway. And then over there is gonna be the bathroom. So I'll show you that in a minute. We're gonna take you through the kitchen. What is that?
I meant to spell B, but I think I spelled it wrong.
It's been a long day. Oh well. So you're X-ing out the areas we're gonna demo, right?
Yeah, okay. So originally we were gonna do, we were gonna maintain the footprint of this kitchen, but the problem is that there's no way to get drawers in here. It's just a mess. And then we would have to buy all small appliances, which are usually twice as expensive as regular size appliances. So this is an exterior wall, so this is load bearing. But it's not that large of a space, so you can easily do a beam there. So we're gonna do a beam there. That will allow us to have a stove here, sink, probably some drawers on each side of the sink. I think we're still gonna have a problem with drawers.
Well, you can put, we were planning on putting drawers here, but now that we've decided to knock this wall down.
So I think what we'll have to do is, instead of a dead space cabinet, we'll have to do a drawer cabinet here, and then dishwasher, fridge, and then
washer and dryer.
Washer and dryer.
So washer and dryer in this area, huh?
And microwave. Okay. Yeah. So
and microwave.
The fridge would start about right here and go 30 inches this way.
Okay.
And then another 30 inches, so a total of 60 inches, with probably like 2 or 3 inches of clearance. But that would solve a lot of the problems in this kitchen, because the biggest problem is like,
so small.
If you open drawers, or you open the dishwasher, or you open the stove, then there's no space. So the other thing we can do is we can put short cabinets on this side that have drawers. So that might be the solution. You couldn't do that before because you would be blocking this walkway because your cabinets are like 24 inches out. So, now with this gone, right, that's like 48 to 52 inches of walking space. You can put lower cabinets in here. And you can save yourself some money by doing nothing up here or doing floating shelves. Then you would have your microwave right here. So this would be your microwave, stove, sink.
So that's the deal with the kitchen. This is like the living area. So we'll put a TV maybe on that wall. I don't know, couch or even on that wall. And then kitchen table, washer and dryer. So this is the back bedroom. Oh, and by the way, all the floors we've ripped up. We could not save them, unfortunately, because they were really damaged, but they're the original hardwood floors. We found out that this is an old marijuana grow operation. I don't know quite yet what we're gonna do with it, but we'll probably just have to cover it up. It's quite big underneath. Like, you can stand up and it's a big, huge walking, like almost like a bedroom down there. It's very big, but it'd be a lot of work to like remove all the stuff. This is a really tiny bedroom, as you can see. We're gonna demo the ceiling and we're gonna demo, knock down that wall, knock down all this. So it's like more open because we're actually extending this bedroom out here. So this wall will be gone. And so this bedroom will become much bigger. We're building a wall here. So that'll be like the door into the bedroom instead of that door, because that'll be gone. Looking back this way, like I said, there'll be a wall here, a door into the bedroom there. And so the room will be a lot bigger. Let's take you guys into the bathroom. I just have to be very careful because there's stuff everywhere. Okay, so toilet. This is a very awkward layout. This wall will be gone. Of course, all this will be gone, but we're probably gonna keep this same layout, but with this wall gone.
So this wall will be gone, this tub will be gone. All this will be new drywall, and then this will be gutted. This whole wall will be gutted. This goes about a foot back into here.
It's hard to see.
Because they put their water stuff in here. So basically, we'll do a brand new big shower that will take up all this back area, and this will be gone. So it won't be a bathtub, it'll just be a shower. And the shower will be like this, but this wall will be gone. So you'll have all this space to walk into. Originally we were gonna try to put the washer dryer here, but the problem is how tight this is. When you open the door, it is just gonna bang this thing.
Yeah, so this is gonna be gone.
This wall can't go anywhere because this is the staircase, so this is a load bearing. But we can open this up to give it a more airy feeling. There'll still be a post here, but there'll be, and again, we'll have to see. If we do that, that's gonna be a little bit more expensive. So yeah, and then standard vanity here. We always do IKEA vanities because they have slow clothes and they're nice. All this will be gone. We'll move this up here. So this will be vanity light here.
Love your acronyms.
Hopefully the contractor doesn't think that means demo that wall.
But there's no X, so hopefully.
But yeah, all the ceilings are gonna come down. This bathroom is, you can kind of see all the water damage here. Part of that's because it wasn't properly installed, but then if you look up here, you can see there's like mold, surface mold here, and that's because there's no vent in here and that window barely opens. So When the siding guys were here, I had them put a vent so that there's gonna be a shower fan and the vent will go out that way.
So we exit the bathroom and then we're back to where we started.
All new windows coming next week, or October 1st, all new windows, which will be nice because none of the windows in here open. The only thing that opens is that door and that small window. I think it's stuck now. It used to open, but it doesn't anymore. So basically, on a hot day, it was like a stove in here. I'm gonna do LVP on the floors, drone rooms, paint on the walls. Am I being annoying with this?
Okay, so we thought we'd share our plans and I think that's about it. So we'll be documenting our journey with this unit also. So love to have you guys along for the ride. And also, if you're brand new and coming across these videos for the first time, welcome. I upload 1 or 2 videos a week all about living healthy. And then of course, we're just renovating like crazy. So that's also a large part of my life. So I'll document that, of course. Make sure you give this video a like if you liked it, because it really helps support my channel. And always remember to be kind to yourself.